Five things I wish I knew before I start trading. Now, since we're working with many students, people around the world, and beginners most of all, one of the most frequent question is, what would be your advice for someone who's just starting, okay, in this career, in this trading world, in this trading business, okay? If you had the chance, what would you do differently when you started trading? So because that question circulates our community pretty much all the time, I've decided to create this video, guys, with the top 5 things I believe any new trader should be considering. So the first thing, I would first of all consider the higher time frames. Why? One very simple reason. The higher time frames are much easier to deal with. Okay, there is no so much noise. Anything that you would be trading in terms of strategy or method, measuring indicators, whatever is it that you do on the higher time frames would make much more sense. Okay, if you're trading patterns, for example, do you think 1 minute chart triangle is as reliable as the 4 hour chart or the daily triangle breakout? Okay, do you think 1 minute RSI extreme is significant enough as the 4 hour chart RSI extreme? All right, and this is just where it starts. There are many more advantages of trading the higher time frames. That would be, of course, that you have more time to go ahead and do your analysis. You have more time to react about what you're going to do, right? If you're trading the 5 minute chart and you're just starting out, you're under time pressure because any second you lose, the market is moving. Pip up or a tick down, it means you lost or won. That means you're under pressure when you're opening the position. That means you're going to make mistakes, and instead of 0.2 lots, you will be opening 2 lots, for example, okay, or 20 lots. Believe me, guys, we've seen that live on real accounts, and it's not fun at all, okay? One more thing, spreads. When you're dealing with the 4 hour chart entry, for example, and your target is, say, 200 pips or 150 pips, paying a spread of 5, 6, 3, 7, it won't change that much. When you're dealing, however, with the 5-minute chart, and your target is 10 pips, and you have a spread of 7 pips or 6 pips or 5 pips even, things change completely. Okay? So that's the first thing I would advise anyone who's just starting trading. Guys, stick to the higher time frames. Don't drop lower than the 1 hour chart. Okay, stick to the 1 hour chart, 4 hour chart, 8, depending on your platform. But anything above 1 hour should be good enough for you to start smooth. Alright, guys, number 2. We have to work with facts and not wishes or dreams. In other words, if you cannot prove to yourself that you can make money consistently, that you can follow your money management, that you can follow your risk management, okay, that you can deliver profits for at least, let's say, 100 trades or 150 trades, or give it a time range, 3 months, 4 months, 6 months, why do you believe you will be able to make money on a live account? Okay, one is virtual money, the other one is real money. And there is a huge debate here, okay, I'm aware of that. Many people are claiming that you can't get the real experience if you're not trading real money, you cannot simulate the emotions, okay, you cannot feel terrified, you cannot feel horror, you cannot feel excited, okay, all these emotions, adrenaline, everything that comes with trading cannot be simulated if you're trading a demo account, right? And I do agree with that. But let me ask you this. Do pilots go to the aircraft immediately as soon as they sign up? Okay. If you're a surgeon, do you go operating people as soon as they sign up? I don't think so. The key here is practice. You must be able to perform the given action up until perfection, guys. All right? And I'm not saying that just because. I'm saying that because this is your money. This is my money. Okay? This is someone else's money. You start here a business. Trading is not gambling. Trading comes attached with many rules. We're not just clicking the sell and buy button. We're not flipping the roulette slot or gambling on the... You got the point. Okay? We're doing a process of learning, and once that's complete, we go and actually invest money. We invest, we don't gamble, we don't just hope that it will be black or red or it will be 17. Okay? We don't just hope the price will go up or down. We have statistics, we have knowledge, we use different methods that are giving us the clue whether the price is going up, down, sideways, or whatever it's going to do. Based on that, we take our decisions. So until you master how to fly on an airplane, you don't sit in an airplane transporting people, right? Number three, don't follow the crowds. One of the very first things you're going to learn in the trading world is that majority of the people unfortunately lose money, guys. Okay? And when we say that, it's crazy that still some people go forums, websites, I don't know, just anywhere on the internet, and they listen to other people and then make certain decisions about their trades based on this small comment from someone who's probably falling into the category of losing money anyways. Why would you do that? Okay? You must build up confidence in order to follow your own decisions and believe in yourself. Okay? If you have, I don't know, a bookstore and someone comes to you and tells you, listen, this book doesn't sell. And you have no idea who this guy is, okay? He might be a taxi driver, he might be, I don't know, a chef in a restaurant, and he comes and tells you, this book doesn't sell. Take it off the shelves, stop selling it. Would you do it? Okay, this is the absolutely same thing. Someone, you have no idea who this person is saying, this thing is going up. Do you know what time frame he's talking about? He might be talking about next 2 years, and you're trading the 1 hour chart in combo with the 4 hour chart. All right, so make sure you don't blindly follow the crowds. Having people around you, having a community around you that you can share and talk about trading ideas is one thing. Blindly following someone else's idea just because they said so doesn't mean anything. Okay? I'm telling you that from my personal experience. I used to do it. It got me nowhere. You must build yourself as a trader. Okay? Have your own set of skills. Have your own understanding of how things work, and that's why first of all you need to practice whatever we mentioned before, and then you start moving forward, believing in your own statistics, believing in your own knowledge, and doing what you saw with your eyes works. Otherwise, how do you know that this person that you're following for some reason is making money? Okay? And now speaking about crowds and communities, when you start researching, because unfortunately the internet is full of crap and many people are selling stuff that literally don't work at all, guys, do your own research, okay? Do your homework and make sure you understand who you're buying from. First of all, look for people who have reputable names, brands, or whatever is going to be, right? Don't just fall for the become a millionaire in 3 weeks kind of thing. That doesn't exist. Okay, this is a real business as any other business, which requires a lot of effort, a lot of time, a lot of failure. Okay, think about it this way. Don't just think you're going to click buy sell 30 times and you duplicate or triplicate your money. Okay? Be realistic. So immediately filter out the people who are selling dreams and the stars. That doesn't exist, guys. It simply doesn't exist. This is the very first clue you're going to get once you start looking for quality education. Then go to forums, look for feedbacks, look for people who have some kind of experience with these guys. Okay? Baby steps. Okay? You should understand that you can't learn something that takes probably months or years to master in a blink of an eye. It doesn't work this way. How long did you take to learn to drive a car? How long did you take to learn to crawl first of all, then to walk, then to jump, and then to run? Okay? Things take time. This is how life works. Good things take even more time. So I don't understand, because we're working with many people in the Traders Academy Club, why people are so impatient. You just got your hands on something, you go through it the first time, you start applying it, and then you fail, and then you move on to the next thing, trying to understand, okay, maybe this is going to work if I do the same thing. This is absolutely the definition of madness. Repeating the same thing over and over again, expecting different outcome, doesn't work this way. When you were learning to ride a bicycle, how long did it take you to do that? Okay, if you remember, because it probably was a long time ago when you were a child. But same principles apply, guys, okay? Take something, dedicate the time to learn this one very specific thing. Stick to it. Weeks, days, months, years, whatever it takes, do it. Once you come to the perfection point, okay, then you're ready to move on. But let's stop here for a second and think about it. If you have just, again, let's take the bookshop example. You're selling hundreds, thousands of books, okay, and you have one bestseller. You take this bestseller, you look at your statement, okay, that book was selling for 3 months consistently, it's very hot, people like it, let's do something with that. So you take this book and you put it in the front, okay, right next to the door, you get all these advertising materials and you push it even further. That thing starts to generate even more income. Same idea here. Once you have a bestseller in your hands, once you master something, stick to it, start making money with it. This is going to build up your confidence, this is going to build up your account, and everything starts to be smoother from that point on. And that's just the first thing. Now, let's leave that somewhere stuck, making money for us, and then we're able to start learning new things. So we go through the same process. Takes months, weeks, days, years, whatever it takes for us to master this new thing, new strategy, new method. And then we have two working methods together. Then we're able to move on to the next one and to the next one if needed. Okay, many people, they find their thing because they put the time and effort into this thing. They learned how to do it, and that's more than enough for them. But if you're willing to expand your knowledge and you want to do more and more and more, separate each of those methods or strategies on its own. Okay, the next one on the list is the common concept and understanding that when traders start trading, they're going to blow up their first account. Total nonsense. Nonsense, okay? It makes absolutely nonsense to believe in that. If you believe it, you'll probably blow up not your first account only, but many, many after that. Again, let's go back to the pilots and surgeons. Is the pilot crashing his first plane Is the doctor killing his first patient on the table while performing the surgery? Of course not. Why in Forex, why in trading in general, you have to blow up your first account? Makes no sense, right? So to make sure you don't get there, you follow the steps before. You find quality education. You practice like insane until you can prove yourself that this thing works. And only then you move on to real money. Okay? And once you move on to real money, you have to understand two things. Why do people fail? First of all, I split them into two categories, divide them. Category number one, they didn't have any education at all. They heard something about someone, they watched The Wolf of Wall Street. I don't know, they saw Warren Buffett on the news, they got excited, they started trading, started investing. It worked for two trades, they put 10k on the line, they lose it in 3 days. Game over. This is the first category. Assuming that you did the things before, what we spoke about, you're not going to fall into this category, okay? Category number two. People who have knowledge, people who have skills, people who have trading plan, simply don't follow it. Okay? They simply don't follow it. I don't know how that works, but it just happens. So what's the solution? And this is a very small trick, but it actually works amazing. Okay? I found out this thing, I figured it out once I started teaching other people what to do. Basically, I guess we can call it peer pressure. Okay? If you know people are watching you, okay, there is someone behind your shoulder, you don't do stupid things. You follow your plan. You don't just move the stop loss in hopes of, oh yeah, maybe this will, reverse back and I'm not going to lose the money. No. You don't do that anymore. Okay, so here is my advice. Take your account, link it to my FX book or some other platform out there, or just give your investor password to people or to the community where you're trading, okay? And just be transparent, be open, okay? Be afraid that someone out there is checking your account and trying to understand what you're doing. Why did you enter this trade? Why did you close this trade? Did you open your trade on time? Were you too late? Did you close your trade too early, cutting the profits? Did you move the stop loss? If you have a risk money management that allows you, let's say, to risk 2% per trade, why did you lose 10% on this trade? This kind of psychological pressure that you're being watched works. So if you have a problem sticking to your plan, this is one of the best advice I've ever given to other traders, guys. It's simple, it's free, and it works for everyone. Alright, so go ahead, try it, and you'll see the results very, very soon. So that would be all. I hope you like this video. If you have other questions on the subject, let me know. I'll be happy to reply. Thank you for watching and have a wonderful one.